Christway Church welcomes you. Let's hear what God has to say through Pastor Annu.
Let Satan be powerless in our life. That's the topic of our message this morning. In Romans 16, 19 and 20, Paul asks us to be wise as to be what is good and innocent as what is evil. God of peace will soon crush Satan under your feet. If Satan was crushed under Jesus' feet, the good news is that he will be crushed under our feet, provided we walk in Christ's way. One of the most important truths about life is that all humans have a supernatural enemy whose aim is to pain us, take pleasure, to take us to be in a secluded place where he wants us to believe that there is no God. He wants us to make us blind in our sins and all about the truth of God and make our life miserable. This is the aim of our enemy, and this is his aim, you have to believe. Ephesians 6:12 states that, "For we wrestle not against the flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers and the rulers and the darkness of this world, against the spiritual wickedness in high places." These words are addressed to the Christian folks only. There is no message here for those who are not Christians, because the world today ridicules this kind of statement. The world today don't believe in the supernatural realm of spirit, and the world don't believe in Satan. Even many of the believers don't believe in Satan. So a vast majority of people don't believe the supernatural realm at all. They don't believe that there is a supernatural power, that is Satan, that is working against them all the time. And they don't believe that there are principalities, powers and the rulers of darkness of this world and the spiritual wickedness in the high places or in the low places, as Bible explains. But to those of us who believe, who say we are born again, baptized, these words should help us and have a real encouragement. Ephesians 5:8 says, "Once we too were in darkness, but now we are in the light of God, so we should walk as the children of light." And verses 10 says, "We should try to discern what is pleasing to God." That is very important. If we know what is pleasing to God, or we should discern what is pleasing to God, and if we do them only, we can live against the wiles of this enemy. None of us can ignore or be ignored and hide from this supernatural battle that is real and ongoing. It is not an illusion, or it is not some made story. As born again Christians, we are delivered from the power of the air, that is Satan, and he has power over every disobedient child. Whoever, even if a person in Christ is disobedient, he has the power over that person. And God has delivered us from the Satan through cleansing all our sins and given us a personality that is without sin nature. We can live today without sin. Romans 6:12-14. We are called to live a sinless life, to be delivered from Satan. Whoever is not practicing righteousness is practicing sin. Whoever is not practicing righteousness is deliberately practicing sin, I should tell. And they are called the children of Satan, Bible says in 1 John 3:7-10. So never underestimate the devil. The devil is real. His opposition and enmity are something to be considered very seriously every day of our life, that we are fighting against not a human enemy, but a supernatural enemy. How dangerous is a human enemy? Then just think of this supernatural enemy. You don't have to be worried if you can walk with Jesus Christ. Okay? You can really have victory over this supernatural enemy. But if you are rebellious and if you are still fighting to walk with Jesus Christ, you have to be worried about him. Your ignorance is not a bliss, or your ignorance cannot help you to be away from this enmity that is happening in you. So What we are fighting against is not just human weakness, but a supernatural demonic power. Psychological counseling and self-help group may solve some problems, but they don't help us with this power. They don't even believe in this power. Their medicine or their counseling cannot help us to overcome this power, which is called Satan. And they cannot help us to defeat the enemy's power against us. Enemy's power in us is what? Our sins. So what psychology can help us? Tell me. What medicine can help us? Only Jesus Christ can help us. Hallelujah. So the battle we fight with our enemy, we fight for the Lord. God has to fight through us with our enemy and win for us. Please note that point. Through we doing righteousness. 1 Samuel 17:47, 2 Chronicles 20:15, Psalms 110:1, and 1 Corinthians 15:25. That is the reason living a righteous life is very, 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 very important for us. It is not our choice. Hallelujah. Many believers do not understand this truth. They think as long as they pray and trust God, nothing can go wrong and Lord will look after them. They don't bother about their sins. Even if they sin like Old Testament people, they come back to God and say, God, forgive me. Again, they start committing the same sin without any commitment because they think that Jesus Christ has done everything on the cross for them. So they don't have to do anything for their sins. Just they can ask forgiveness. To such Christians, such born-again believers, Satan is very happy. So they don't learn to live a life resisting Satan's temptation in them. They keep falling in their sins and live in their pride, ego, unforgiveness, selfishness, jealousy, etc., etc., continuously, and say that God is with me. And say that I'm the child of God. Bible is telling all those who are not practicing righteousness are the children of Satan. But they cannot agree. They say, just because they are born again baptized, just because they have some spiritual gift in them, so they can see some vision or they can prophesy. They can see something in the spiritual realm. They can understand something in the spiritual realm. So they are thinking that God is with them. Then, this is contradicting, no? 1 John 3:7-10. Ephesians 4:26-27. Apostle Paul is warning us through these verses. He says, be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath, nor give Satan an opportunity. These verses are teaching us, how do we give opportunity or how do we allow Satan into our life? Here is one example, that is anger. Paul says, we can have sinless anger. This is not a selfish anger. That doesn't mean that you keep getting angry and telling that, we can get anger. You will only point out what Jesus Christ has done. And you will compare your anger with Jesus Christ's anger. Please be very careful when you compare your anger with Jesus Christ's anger. What was Jesus Christ's anger? His anger was out of his love and care. Your anger is that? If your anger is not that, don't take the name of Lord in vain. Please, the verses of Bible are not to convey it as a joke. That is called in the Bible, in the Ten Commandments, it says, don't take the name of the Lord in vain. Be very careful about this. So, selfish anger will become sin, where we don't be able to be happy and peaceful. How do you know your anger is not Christ's anger? After you release your anger, do you have peace and joy? What will be running in your heart? Your anger is out of your impatience. Your anger is out of your lack of tolerance. Isn't it? Then how can you compare your anger to be holy anger? Please don't take the name of God in vain. Emotion of any sin in us opens the door for devil in our life. Ongoing unrepentant sin gives the enemy an entrance point into our life. That tiny foothold, he turns into a stronghold. Foothold and stronghold. Foothold is the entrance. Stronghold is his fortress where he make a palace inside of us. He's living inside. How do we know He's living inside? Think of your thoughts. Any control for your thoughts? You are not able to control your thought. That means you have a stronghold there. I am not going to explain here before I have explained. That is the reason. 1 Peter 5:8, Peter wants us to be sober and be watchful as your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion. By falling in sin, we make Satan entrance into our life. And if we don't understand, he will make a foothold in our life. What Satan can do to us through our sin, Ephesians 4:27 wants us, give no opportunity to devil. What does this mean? Let me slightly explain. You have to understand this. Devil may be ruling you without your understanding. Devil may be lord over you before you understand. You may be thinking Christ is your Lord because you are praying, you are going to church, you are reading the Bible. But what is running in your heart depends upon that. You can understand who is ruling over you. So, Paul is telling, give no opportunity to devil. Proverbs 26:2 says, a curse doesn't come without a cause. Anyone can set a foundation for a curse to operate in his life through his own sins. Don't forget. We bring curses into our life through our own sins. Another truth is, what we sow is what we reap. Deuteronomy 11:26-28 say, behold, I set before you today blessing and cursing. The blessing, if you obey the commandments of God, your Lord, which I command you today. And the curse, if you don't obey the commandment. Oh, this is very difficult to digest, isn't it? Curse. Bible is telling in Deuteronomy 11:28, the verses, and the curse if you don't obey my commandments. All these are applicable today also. And Deuteronomy 28:15-44, you have to go home and read about the curses that is written in the Bible that is applicable for the born again Christians today also. Hallelujah. Malachi 2:2 says, if you don't honor your God, your blessings will be cursed. If you don't honor your God, your Lord, today whatever you are holding as your great blessing, whatever, maybe a relationship, maybe a lot of money, maybe your health, maybe your education, whatever. He's telling, let's read once again. Malachi 2:2. If we don't honor God, our blessings will be cursed. You have no guarantee for whatever you are holding on today. You are thinking, yes, you have locked. And you are thinking, yes, this is safe. No. Look into your heart. Depends upon your heart. You can say it is safe or not, my friends. Understand? And Malachi 3:9 says, if we use God's portion of money from our income, we will be cursed with a curse. What does this mean? We will be cursed with a curse. As we are robbing God. Cursed with a curse means we are greatly cursed and the curse shall continue. Cursed with a curse. Don't keep all your money for yourself and say that, no money, no money, no money. That only I can hear from the mouth of the people. Our giving is always like the poor widow's giving. You should know to give out of nothing. Out of abundance, everybody can give. When you have a giving heart, even nothing is there also, you will give. That is called giving because God said to do so. You are honoring God. But if you say you don't have money and you are keeping all your money for yourself, maybe you don't have money, but you are dishonoring God. Hallelujah. Though tithing is not a commandment in New Testament, giving to God and to His people are still a commandment, my people, understand? Jesus himself says that in Matthew 22:21. How do we give place to devil? Through our own sins and unchecked, negative and sinful emotions. That is what is going on each time. Look at your emotion. You have no joy. Bible is telling rejoice always. Rejoice, I say, rejoice. Be peaceful. We are not able to. Look into your heart and see your emotions. That is what Satan is using. Hallelujah. Most believers are so worldly minded that they never realize the actual source of enemy's attack. As long as you are a worldly minded person, you will not understand all these emotions. This will be running in you, but still you say, no, I'm happy. I'm very, very happy. If you are a godly minded person, God will convict you, whatever is there inside of you, my friends, understand. So, most believers are so worldly minded that they never realize the actual source of enemy's attack. They blame circumstances and people for their lack of self-control and frequent sins. By this, they are bringing curses into their life. Whom can you blame? For your tragedy, whom can you blame? God has brought you in Christ to live a blessed life. After you have come to Jesus Christ, don't blame anyone. Don't blame your father, mother, sister, brother, wife, husband, or your situation for your tragedy. You can overcome that tragedy through being closer to God Almighty. If you fill your mind with worry, fear, grumbling, anger, resentment, ungratefulness, jealousy, ego, pride, selfishness, or any sin, Satan can gain a foothold into your life. That means once Satan enters into our life, he causes those sinful and negative thoughts, he will make them increase. He has that power. That is happening. That will happen. Once you give Satan an entrance into your heart, something is happening. Like you have given flame to the fire. Hallelujah. He causes the sinful and negative thoughts to increase. Thoughts of your sinful nature will increase in your subconscious mind. You do those sins as a result and receive the curses from your own sins. Temptation is one of the devil's main weapons. Temptation means a trial which man has free choice of being faithful to God or not. We are tempted when we are attracted or enticed to do something wrong. You have a choice. When a temptation comes, you have a choice whether to do it or not. Whether to be faithful to God or not. Depends on that you give place to Satan. You experience temptation when a thought comes into your mind and you are aware of that thought. We are aware of every thought. We are aware of every thought. Look into your heart. Whether it's right or wrong, you can understand. It is your decision to clinging on to which thought. Hallelujah. A sinful or negative thought is something that goes against God's will and His laws. And we think according to our own human nature, James 1, 14 and 15, that is according to the sinful tendencies that dwell in us. And verses 14 says, each person is tempted when he is drawn away by his own desires. You are aware of that. To give in to certain thought would be sin or what? Friends, not this point. You are aware. You are aware. When you are sad, you are aware. Why don't you rejoice immediately? Because you enjoy your sadness. You should meditate this verse, James 1:12, in your mind. What it says? We receive our eternal life that God has promised only after passing every test and tribulation. Oh, believers don't want to hear all these verses. They want to hear some blessing verses. Prophets should come to the pulpit and say, that blessing is coming, this blessing is coming. Yes, it is coming, but your sins will stop them. The deep truth they will not tell you. That only teachers can tell you. God wants to bless us, of course. God wants to reward us with whatever you are asking. You may be asking, so God is telling, that is coming, that is coming. That is true. It is not wrong thing they are prophesying. You are aware that to give it to certain thought would be to sin, to do what you know to be wrong. You know that. So you sin with your own knowledge willingly. This is very dangerous. My friends, understand, willingly you are choosing that temptation. Now you have the knowledge of God. You are not ignorant. Before you were in darkness. Now God has brought you to the light. Isn't it? So you are choosing to be in sin. You get more punishment. Where it is written, Luke 12, 47, 48. The servant who knows what the master wants but still not ready will be punished with more blows. But the servant doesn't know what the master wants, still he is doing. He will also get punishment, but less blows. You will maybe thinking, I could have not come to church. God has brought you. You may be thinking, I could have not taken baptism. God has done for your blessing. Don't fight with that because you want to be in your rebellion. So, the servant who knows what the master wants, my friends, always rejoice. Be happy. Be content with what you have. Have control over your character. Pray, I will give you strength. But you are not doing anything. You have no self-control, but still you will argue and justify that. I don't have that sin. That means that much Satan's influence is there in your heart, my friend. Whoever is telling that, Satan is ruling you that strongly. Only such person can be ignorant or to show himself to be ignorant. Or he may not be knowing because Satan is ruling him. That may be the truth. Okay. And it's important to remember that you cannot be tempted without a thought first coming into your mind. Hallelujah. Did you get that point? That thought is only the temptation. That thought is not a sin. That thought is a temptation. To choose to be in that sin, it is your decision. Did you get me? Hallelujah. It's important to understand that as long as you are fighting your thoughts to overcome, you are not sinning. But if you are not fighting your thoughts to overcome, you are sinning. Did you get this point? Hallelujah. I repeat, the thought that is coming into your heart is only the temptation. You can choose whether to keep thinking or not. Or you can choose to overcome. It is in your hand. Don't tell that I am very weak, feeble. I don't have strength. We are praying for strength for each other. You have to pray. Hallelujah. So if you are not fighting with that thought, you are sinning. But if you are fighting to overcome that thought, you are not sinning. That thought is not a sin, but if you keep thinking, then it is a sin because you are not fighting against. Once Satan enters into your mind, he has power to enhance those thoughts in us. By repetition of our thoughts, we are nourishing them in our subconscious mind. You should understand what is happening in the subconscious mind. I will always make you people understand the spiritual truth with the scientific truth. So that will be wiring in our subconscious mind. That is called the process of myelination. With repetition of every thought, the chemical will be produced to myelin, and myelination will be happening. So you are strengthening that thought in your subconscious. When our subconscious overloads with negativity and sinful thoughts for long, we can experience physical pain somewhere in the body, or some sickness or some health problems begin to manifest as we didn't control our thoughts, and those thoughts produce stress hormones in us. Our lives reflect our subconscious mind programming. Did you get me? Our life reflects our subconscious mind programming. How you have programmed like that you are today. You have no joy, no peace. You will not look at anyone and smile. That is how you have programmed. And you will say always negative. You have no hope, no joy. You keep telling negative. You think you cannot do anything. That is how you have programmed. You have to undo that programming in Christ. Please understand, my friends. So it is because of the job of the subconscious is to create reality out of the program what you have given to the subconscious mind. So how you have programmed your subconscious, you behave exactly the same way. Please note this point. So as human being, you have to realize how much negative and sinful programming you have, like your fear, worry, unforgiveness, doubt, anger, bitterness, impatience, let me tell you, sexual sins, intolerance, etc. from your own daily behavior and from especially when you are in a fire. Those who are telling that you are meditating, you need to increase your meditation. That's the meaning. Don't tell that I am meditating. If your meditation is working, you look different, you behave differently. If your meditation is not working, you are the same person. That means you are meditating in a very lower degree. So studies show that 95% of the time you will create those negative experiences in your life. This is very dangerous for the brain and for the physical health. If you are not conscious to think right and fight against your wrong thoughts consciously, your subconscious is back in charge again to be negative and sinful. Did you get me? Consciously, you have to fight with your thought. Don't say that you are tired. Whom you are telling? You want to enjoy. That's the reason you are telling tired. Hallelujah. You should receive the Holy Spirit. First, you have to ask God, fill me with your strength. If you are doing the fight with your own spirit, you will be tired. But with the Spirit of God, if you are fighting, you will never be tired. Because that is the power of the Holy Spirit is called holy ease. Ease. Hallelujah. So your subconscious is back in action whenever you are conscious of your thoughts. Okay, that you should understand. Unless you spend time in meditation against your negative and sinful thoughts, you cannot undo the existing subconscious thinking. Depends upon how hard you have wired. Needs your meditation time. If it is too strong, you need to spend more time in meditation, meditating the word of God. So unless you spend time in meditation against your negative and sinful thoughts, you cannot undo the existing subconscious thinking. You will reproduce your old behavior very easily, because the subconscious duty is that whatever you have given the order, that will reproduce. He's an innocent part. Subconscious is an innocent part. But that is how you have wired. You should be a watcher of your own thoughts, my friends. Understand? Example. One common example I can tell. Most of us are sad all the time. Isn't it? Because that much negativity you have wired in your subconscious mind. So just because meditating, I'm happy, you will not get happiness. You have to go to God and understand the cause of your sadness. Why are you sad? First, you bring out the cause of your sadness. Write them down. Maybe because of your husband, wife, or children's present situation, you may be worried. So you should trust in God. Pray and trust in God. God will change them. You need tolerance and you need patience. So out loud, you have to talk. Yes, my husband will change, my child will change, my situation will change with happiness. Okay? Or sometimes you are sad because somebody have done something wrong. You keep thinking about that wrongdoing, wrong action of that person. You have to forgive that person. You didn't forgive. That's the reason that thinking is coming and taking over you. I'm not telling the memory will not come. Even if the memory comes, it can go fast if you have forgiven. As long as you have not forgiven, in that memory, the thought will be stronger and stronger. Please understand, from that you can understand whether you have forgiven or not. What Bible says? Pray for those who hurt you. You will tell all the holy verses. But inside, how you are. Check your own thoughts. From that you can understand. So you have to go before God and you have to understand the cause for your sadness. Bring them out. Meditate against that. Then you have to keep claiming, keep meditating, I am happy, I am peaceful. If you are not ready to be like Jesus Christ, if you keep meditating, I am like Jesus Christ, I am like Jesus Christ, you will be like Jesus Christ. You can't deal with even one character of yours. First you have to submit. Humble down before God and be ready and say, I will change. I want to change. I want to be holy like Jesus Christ. Before that submission, you cannot meditate. That is worldly meditation. With stuffing all their sins inside, they will meditate. Actually, the researchers are finding that is giving more damage to them because they are expecting something. They are expecting something. They are not getting it. But in Christ, that is not the story. We will get it if we go through the righteous way. Because what can stop our blessing is only our sin. So Christ will help us to overcome our sins and help us what we ask according to God's will. So we will not be frustrated in our meditation, but the worldly people will be frustrated in their meditation and positive thinking. They are just chanting some positive thinkings, and because that is what encouraging them. But the sins are stuffed inside. With the sin, God will not bless. That supernatural power, they don't believe. Hallelujah. So you cannot stop these negative and sinful thoughts, which are your temptations, from coming into your daily thoughts. But you can disagree with those thoughts and stop it from affecting your spirit, your subconscious. You can become free of these negative subconscious patterns in your mind by becoming aware of them and spend time in meditating the word constantly. My friends, meditating is very important. Prayer and meditating. Without prayer, don't meditate. Then it will be like the worldly meditation. You should understand what you are going through, why you are going through. You should understand why you don't have peace, why you don't have certain things. Then you should submit to God for what He demands and then start meditating. Then when you start meditating, you should understand this is not an illusion. This is what is happening in our brain, myelination. Myelin will be produced in our brains for each repetition, for anyone. Please understand, it is not an illusion, but this is what is happening in our brain. Hallelujah. So Satan is clever and powerful, and no human being can successfully resist his influence without God's help. Therefore, key to resisting the devil is to sincerely and consistently draw near to God in submission and prayers and in meditation. This is what is written in James 4:7, but the detail is not written. What it says, submit yourself to God and resist the devil, he will flee from you. That means if you are not submitting yourself to God, Satan will never flee from you. In your path, Satan is coming. Hallelujah. So God expects a life of repentance, the act of regretting sincerely the sins of your flesh, not to do again. It has to do with your attitude, what you want more. Eternal life with Jesus Christ or passing the pleasure of the sin. Make more money and enjoy this life with all your sin in your heart. And how? Curses later. It is your choice. Yes, sin has got pleasure. I am not telling. That is momentary pleasure, but curse is coming later. You have to think what you want. You want to enjoy the pleasures of your sin or controlling them to do righteousness and to have eternal life. It is your choice. Hallelujah. Then you will never agree with the wrong thoughts that is coming into your mind. Hence, let's understand, because of the circumstances of the world, because of the difficulties of this life, and because of our sinful nature, we are called to a battle. Every Christian should be a fighter. We are not called to a life of ease, you should understand. But we are called to a battle, to a warfare, to wrestle and to struggle. We are called to wrestle with the supernatural wickedness in the high places. Don't take this lightly or indifferently. So we are called, or we are ordered by God, to be strong in the Lord. We sang this song this morning. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We are waiting for God's strength. I will explain what is that strength. It is not that when we wait upon the Lord, all the blessings keep coming by keep fasting and praying. Strength will come when we wait upon the Lord. So we are commanded to be strong in the Lord and His power and His might by putting on the whole armor of God. These armor of God are written in Ephesians 6. 10 through 18, he compares this armor of God to be belt of truth of God. We should understand the truth of God Otherwise, Satan will battle with you with the worldly thoughts and the breastplate of righteousness, that is our ongoing daily righteousness through our self-control, and the shield of faith in God and His Son Jesus Christ, and the helmet of salvation, that is your desire to reach heaven and not to enjoy the pleasure of the sin today and have curses later. That is called the helmet of salvation, like how the helmet give protection while driving. This helmet will give protection while we live in our daily life. Hallelujah. Many of you are not wearing helmet and riding the scooter. To such people, I am telling to wear the helmet of salvation. My dear friends, wear your helmet and go. That is the government rule. To such people, I am telling, I am seeing the believers are only not wearing the helmet and driving. Then, how can they wear this helmet of salvation? Helmet of salvation is our protection. Please understand, you should always desire, yes, I should not lose my salvation. I should reach heaven. I'm not going to enjoy the pleasures of the sin and pleasures of the money. I'm not going to be a people pleaser. People will come against me. I will stand for God. Persecution will be there. I will fight against. Persecution is the another way to heaven, my friends. Understand. Don't escape from the persecution and tell I cannot come to church because of the persecution at home. Hallelujah. Shield of faith and the helmet of salvation. Then the sword of the spirit. That is, spirit is our subconscious. The sword. The sword is the word of God. With the word of God, you have to fill and rewire your subconscious mind. That is the sword of the spirit. Now I am simplifying it more. Hallelujah. And the prayers for all the saints. Then the gospel of peace on your feet, which most of you are not doing. Your readiness to proclaim the gospel of peace is another weapon against Satan. You cannot pick and choose whichever you want. You have to wear all the armor of God. Then only you look like a soldier. Soldier has to be fully armed, isn't it? So whatever is possible, don't take and say that only this much armor I can wear. Then Satan will come through other ways. All the armor, prayers, faith, helmet of salvation, the word of truth, everything should be there. Your ministry to help the people for their salvation. Then you will be protected. Hallelujah. The baby Christians don't want to hear all these. Baby Christians want to come and sit and warm up the chair and go. Sunday morning, they have the attendance in the church, and baby Christians don't like this deeper teaching. I'm not for baby Christians. Yes, initially you are a baby Christian. I'm there to grow you up for your own blessing. I'm there to protect you from this Satan. I'm there to protect you from all the curses that your sins can bring and take you to a blessed life. So don't get offended by my teaching. Hallelujah. So Satan is real and he is man's enemy. Christ's concern for us is to remove evil influences from our hearts and minds, thus protect us from the evil that come to harm us. Ephesians 5, 25 through 27, we read, Christ loved the church and gave himself for her that he might sanctify and cleanse her, her means church, with the washing of the water by the word of God. And he might present her to himself a glorious church. He will not cleanse a person who is away from the church and sitting at home and telling, I am with God. God is with me. Eh? Everything is given to the church. That's the reason. Every blessing is for a person in the church. Every blessing for an individual is through the church. Please understand. When the guidance comes, don't get offended and come with your own interpretation. Hallelujah. You can read these verses written in Ephesians 5, 25 through 27. So Christ is for the individuals in the church as Christ is for the church. Church is not one individual staying at home, isn't it? He should be attached to the other people. Huh? When you don't like the smell of the other sheep, you will go, ayo, that sheep is smelling. Why? I cannot adjust with that sister or brother. All the sheep have to flock together. Different smells are there. Isn't it? You have to bear with them. That is called church. To train you to bear the different smells, stinky smells of the sheep, you are in the church. Those who don't like, they will leave the church and be alone and tell, you don't need any church. There are many. You can open the internet and read. No need of church. Gods are writing. Hallelujah. I have to tell, gods are only writing. Misleading the people. Who will be misled? Gods only will be misled because they don't want a shepherd. Others will not read. They know that it is wrong. Immediately they will delete. If it is possible, they may delete that website also. When I used to get that much of anger to such articles. Hallelujah. So, God will wash our sins through the teachings and counseling through the church. Thus, individuals will be delivered from the influence of Satan in their lives and be blessed. Where Satan will attack you? In your mind. In your mind. Understand. Hallelujah. So remember, you can be strong in the Lord only through pure thinking. Only through a pure heart according to the word of God. Be strong in the Lord and His might. That purity. Those who are pure in their heart be blessed. Those who are pure in the heart will reach heaven. That purity of the heart you need to be strong in the Lord. Spend more time in meditating the word of God and in prayers, my friends, every day. Don't be fed up. Don't be fed up. Never ignore the meditation of the word of God. Submission, prayer and meditation. These three things you have to increase. Don't take it lightly. Wherever you are strong, that much you have wired your subconscious, you should know. You have to undo those wiring. It is not that easy. Because whatever may be your age, that much you are wired. Then how much you have to undo that wiring? How much meditation you need? If you just spend 2 minutes, 3 minutes, it will not work. Hallelujah. To undo all your old subconscious wiring and to have new subconscious wiring, you need to change your thinking consciously through spending the time in meditation because you behave exactly the same way you program your subconscious. Did you get me? Let's close our eyes in prayers.